Hello everyone, today we are going to see the second chapter in geography, which is Inside Our Earth. Synopsis of the lesson. In this session, we are going to see the following topics. The first one is layers of the earth. Under this, we have crust, mantle and core. Next, we have rocks. Then classification of rocks. Rocks are classified into three, that is igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. First, let's see about what is geography. The word geography comes from two Greek words. Geo means earth and graphos means to write about or description. So the word geography means to write about the earth, in other words, the description of the earth. Geography is the study of earth and its peoples, places and environments, the discovery of the world around us and how people interact with their surroundings. Students, did you ever break or open your toy as a child to see what makes it work? It is a natural human tendency to be curious about how things work. We see and hear of earthquakes, volcanoes, lava, etc. But where does it come from? In this chapter, we shall see what is inside the earth and how it keeps changing form. First, we are going to learn about layers of the earth. The planet earth on which we live is shaped like a huge ball, which is not absolutely spherical. Here, spherical means sphere shaped, round or circular. So, the planet Earth on which we live is shaped like a huge ball, which is not absolutely spherical. Here, spherical means sphere-shaped, round or circular. As we look around where we live, we see stretches of land. Here we can see the picture of stretches of land. As we look around where we live, we see stretches of land and water bodies. Small water bodies than oceans like puddle, pond, lake, river and sea. If we travel further, we see huge seas and oceans. Here we can see the pictures of ocean. If you have visited a beach or seen a picture of it, you would notice that land surface extends under the sea, which is also known as seabed or ocean floor. But all this is just the upper surface of the earth. Here we can see the pictures of seabed or ocean floor. A standard cricket ball has a diameter of 7.3 cm. A football has a diameter of 22.3 cm. And the earth has a diameter of 12,742 km at the equator. Here, diameter means width, length or distance. So, a standard cricket ball has a diameter of 7.3 cm. So here diameter means length or distance. So a standard cricket ball has a length of 7.3 cm. A football has a diameter of 22.3 cm. Here diameter means length or distance. And the earth has a diameter of 12,742 kilometer at the equator. Here also, diameter means width, length or distance. Here we can see the picture of cricket ball, football and earth with its diameter. While a cricket ball is filled with jute or leather, etc., and a football has only air, have you wondered what is inside the earth? First, let's see some keywords. Analyzed, piercing. Here, analyzed means examined, studied or investigated. Piercing means a small hole in a part of the body, typically other than the ears, made so as to insert a ring, stud or other piece of jewelry. So, human beings have been able to drill into approximately 12 km of the earth's surface. This is just like piercing the crust. Here, piercing refers to small hole. So, this is just like small hole in the crust. What lies inside has been studied and analyzed, which means examined or investigated by observing various activities of the dynamic planet, which has been continuously changing. Now, let's see some keywords. Meteoroid, aspects, pertaining. Here, a meteoroid is a solid piece of debris. Here, debris means waste from an object such as a comet, asteroid or meteoroid that originates in outer space and survives its passage through the atmosphere to reach the surface of a planet or moon. Aspects means parts, features or characteristics. Pertaining means relating or referred to. Even the study of meteoroids, which were formed nearly the same time on the Earth, that is 4.6 billion years ago, has revealed many aspects pertaining to the Earth's structure. So, even the study of meteoroids. Here, a meteoroid is a solid piece of debris, which means waste from an object such as a comet, asteroid or meteoroid, which were formed nearly the same time on the Earth, that is 4.6 billion years ago, has revealed many aspects pertaining, which means here aspects means parts. So it has revealed many parts. Pertaining means relating. So it has revealed many parts relating to the Earth's structure. If the Earth is cut open, it would show different layers as depicted in the diagram. Let us study these layers one by one. Here, depicted means showed. So, if the Earth is cut open, it would show different layers as showed in the diagram. Let us study these layers one by one. Do you know, it is estimated that the whole of the ocean crust is about 180 million years old. Here, estimated means valued or assessed. So, it is estimated. So, what is mean by estimated? Estimated means valued or assessed. So, it is valued that the whole of the ocean crust is about 180 million years old. The earth is divided into four main layers like crust, mantle, outer core and inner core. Here we can see the picture of layers of the earth. First, we are going to learn about crust. The uppermost layer of the earth's surface is called the crust. It is the thinnest of all the layers. It is around 35 km thick in the landmass, that is continental areas, and just 5 to 10 km thick under the oceans. The main constituents of the continental mass are silica and alumina. Let me explain this. So, the uppermost layer of the earth's surface is called the crust. It is the thinnest of all the layers. Here, thin means narrow. So, it is the thinnest means narrow of all the layers. It is around 35 km thick. Here, thick means broad, deep or wide. In the landmass, here landmass means continental areas, and just 5 to 10 km thick under the oceans. What is mean by thick? Thick means broad or deep under the oceans. The main constituents of the continental mass are silica and alumina. It is therefore called Cl, C from silica and all from aluminium. The oceanic crust mainly constitutes of silica and magnesium and is thus called Cma, C from silica and Ma from magnesium. So, the oceanic crust mainly constitutes here. Constitutes means forms are composed of silica and magnesium and is thus called Cma, C from silica and Ma from magnesium. Next, we are going to learn about mantle. This layer is about 2900 km thick. It is mainly composed of ferromagnesium silicates. This can be divided into two as the upper and lower mantle. The layers are distinguished by the viscosity of the components. Let me explain this. This layer is about 2900 kilometer thick. Here, thick means broad, deep or wide. It is mainly composed of ferromagnesium silicates. This can be divided into two as the upper and lower mantle. The layers are distinguished. Here, distinguished means famous by the viscosity of the components. Here, viscosity means thickness. So, the layers are famous by the thickness of the components. Next, we are going to learn about core. The core is estimated to be with about 3500 km radius. The core is also divided as outer core and inner core. The inner core is solid and mainly composed of iron, while the outer core is liquid and constitutes iron and nickel. This is thus said to be formed of Ni-Fe, Ni from nickel and Fe from ferrous or iron. The core is at a very high temperature and pressure. Let me explain this. The core is estimated. Here, estimated means valued or assessed to be with about 3500 km radius. The core is also divided as outer core and inner core. The inner core is solid, which means hard, and mainly composed of iron, while the outer core is liquid and constitutes, which means forms or compose iron and nickel. This is thus said to be formed of Ni-Fe, Ni from nickel and Fe from ferrous or iron. The core is at a very high temperature and pressure. Students, do you know the highest point on the Earth's crust is the Mount Everest, and the deepest part of the surface of the Earth is in the Mariana Trench, which is 10,994 meters below the sea level. Now, we are going to learn about rocks. The rocks are the solid mineral materials forming a part of the surface of the Earth and other similar planets. Here, solid means hard. So, the rocks are the hard mineral materials forming a part of the surface of the Earth and other similar planets. The Earth's crust is composed of rocks. A rock is an aggregate of one or more minerals. Here, aggregate means combination. So, a rock is an combination of one or more minerals. Minerals are chemical substances which exist in nature. Rocks are a combination of different kinds of minerals. They occur in many varieties of color. Let me explain this point. So, because of the combination of different kinds of minerals in the rocks, we get a variety of color. Here, we can see the picture of rocks in a variety of colors. Rock is an important natural resource and is found in solid state. Here, solid means hard. It may be hard or soft in nature. An estimation reveals that there are 2000 different types of minerals found on the Earth's surface, out of which only 12 are the basic minerals commonly found all over the Earth. Here, minerals are chemical substances which exist in nature. They may occur either in the form of elements or compounds. Next, we are going to learn about classification of rocks. According to the mode of formation, the rocks are classified into three types as follows: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. Classification of rocks. Rocks are classified into three types, like igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are classified into intrusive igneous rocks and extrusive igneous rocks. Sedimentary rocks are classified into organic and inorganic rocks. Inorganic itself, we have chemical and mechanical. Then, metamorphic rocks are classified into two, thermal and dynamic. So, let's see one by one in detail. In the next class, I have enclosed the classbook instructions in the PDF. Kindly refer it. So now, we have reached the end of this session. Thank you.